Welcome back to another episode of the Mentoring Minute with Dan Comeau. We'll be right back with Dan's Mentoring Minute for this week. But first, let's hear from our podcast sponsors. We want to thank Wall of Fame by Vital Signs. You know, they are on a mission to bring your school's legacy to life. They provide a variety of interactive touchscreen video consoles, along with an extensive library of templates to make it easier than ever to recognize the athletic achievements of your students, both past and present. For ideas on how to showcase your school's diverse history and your proudest moments, go to vitalsignswalloffame.com. Or learn more and get started with your digital Wall of Fame tribute. Call them at 614-981-3589, or you can email them at sales@vitalsignswalloffame.com. That's sales@vitalsignswalloffame.com. We also want to thank Final Forms for their support. Final Forms is the industry leader in registration. But you got to know this, Final Forms is more than just registration. Final Forms is a team, it's technology, and it's a service, okay, that can serve your schools in areas like compliance, communication, and risk management solutions. Final Forms can also help with stakeholders in areas like mobile accessibility, reminders for parents about policies, about physicals, and about all the forms that go along with athletics. Can help with team communication and attendance. Can also help with certification management for coaches. And for ADs, it can help with eligibility, with rosters, all the reports that come across your desk. Plus, it does this with secure language translation and ADA compliance. It's time for you to talk with a team that's walked in your shoes. To take the next steps and find out what Final Forms can do for you, go to finalforms.com/Jake. That's finalforms.com/Jake to get started. We also want to thank Huddle for their support. Remember, at Huddle, we power sports. Over 180,000 teams, including some of the best in the world, use Huddle to help their athletes play better using video and analytics. Huddle's the complete performance platform. They have online tools, mobile and desktop apps, smart cameras like the Huddle Focus. Of course, there's analytics and a whole lot more. Huddle's also built for every level of play, from club and youth teams all the way through high school and college programs. And even the professionals are using Huddle to help their team play at the highest level. You're in pretty good company with over 6 million users, including your student athletes, a lot of their parents, and the coaches of the college teams that you're trying to get to recruit your kids. If you want to find out more about what Huddle can do for you and how your school can become a Huddle school, go to huddle.com and talk to their professionals. Remember, at Huddle, we power sports. We also want to thank Athletic Surveys by LifeTrack and for their sponsorship of the AD Toolbox segment of our podcast. Athletic Surveys by LifeTrack are a quick, easy, and affordable way for you to collect comprehensive data that allows you to evaluate and improve your entire athletic program. Athletic Surveys by LifeTrack also connects you with the 95% of the parents and the players who really love your program, and it gives them a voice to help demonstrate the importance that a positive athletic experience has for them. Go to athleticsurveys.com and check out their testimonials, and then give them a call at 1-800-738-6466, or you can email them at info@athleticsurveys.com to get started. If you've never used a survey to take the pulse of the parents and the players in your program, you're really missing out. Talk to the folks at Athletic Surveys by LifeTrack and let them show you how to take your athletic program from good to great. We also want to thank Sideline Interactive. You know, it's becoming harder and harder to fund an athletic department, but Sideline Interactive's indoor scoring tables and video boards can generate $10,000 or more every year while also creating excitement in the gym and the ultimate game day experience for your student athletes. Go to sidelineinteractive.com or call 832 786-0302 to schedule a live web demo and see their tables and boards in action. You can also email them at sales@sidelineinteractive.com and find out exactly what their fantastic products can do for you. That's sales@sidelineinteractive.com. And we also want to thank Hometown Ticketing, the leading digital ticketing provider to schools and colleges. You can find out more about what Hometown Ticketing can do for you and your program by going to hometownticketing.com. Hometown Ticketing, simple and easy online ticketing. Welcome back, everyone, to another episode of the Mentoring Minute with Dan Comeau. Our regular listeners know Dan is a longtime athletic director here in Florida. He's retired, but he's a certified master athletic administrator. He's currently the chair of our state's mentoring program, and he's a national leader in this area of mentoring. So, Dan Comeau, episode number 26. What do you have for us this week?
Good morning, Jake. You know, I was reading on the educational AD podcast, there was a question. It was twofold. One, are athletic directors required to be in attendance at practices, all practices, which we'll talk about? And what are the purchasing procedures? Who is to buy off on purchasing of athletic equipment? And I thought they were good questions from a new athletic director. And, you know, ADs are required to follow what their administrator and principal want. So every school is going to be different. But I want to talk about best practices of both when and why you should be at practices of teams, and talk about purchasing and how to be consistent and fair to all members of your coaching staff.
Yeah, I actually saw that post that you're referring to where they were talking about, you know, what were, you know, are you required to be at practices or games or things like that? And it was interesting and a little bit scary to see some of the responses that came through. So I know you're going to share it from a best practices perspective. So I'm excited to hear this one. For listeners, we're going to take a quick break. This is the Mentoring Minute. Please stay with us as we say thank you to a couple of our sponsors. We want to thank Athletic Surveys by LifeTrack for their support of the Mentoring Minute and the podcast. Athletic Surveys are a quick, easy, and affordable way for you to collect some comprehensive data that allows you to evaluate and improve every aspect of your athletic department. Athletic Surveys by LifeTrack also gives you the ability to connect with most of your parents and student athletes, and most of them actually love your program. And it gives them an opportunity to share the importance that a positive athletic experience has for them. Go to athleticsurveys.com and check out their testimonials, and then give them a call at 1-800-738-6466, or you can email them at info@athleticsurveys.com to get started. If you've never used a survey to take the pulse of your parents or your student athletes, you're really missing out. Talk to the folks at Athletic Surveys by LifeTrack and let them help you take your athletic program from good to great. We also want to thank Huddle for their support. Remember, at Huddle, we power sports. Over 180,000 teams, including some of the best in the world, use Huddle to help their teams play better using video and analytics. Huddle's the complete performance platform. They have online tools, mobile and desktop apps, smart cameras like the Huddle Focus. Of course, there's analytics and a whole lot more. Huddle is also built for every level of play, from club and youth teams all the way through high school and college programs. And even the pros use Huddle to help their teams play at the highest level. You're in pretty good company with over 6 million users, including your student athletes, a lot of their parents, and the coaches of the college teams you're trying to get to recruit your kids. If you want to find out more about what Huddle can do for you and your program and how your school can become a Huddle school, go to huddle.com and talk to their professionals. Remember, at Huddle, we power sports. We're back with Dan Comeau and the Mentoring Minute. Dan, we've got kind of a twofer today, it sounds like. What are some of those best practices you can share?
Yeah, this is a buy one, get one. We're going to talk about practices and we're going to talk about purchases. And, you know, as you look at a team, the practices usually run, or seasons usually run about 12 to 15 weeks during the regular seasons. And the question was, should an athletic director be at all practices? Well, physically, that's impossible because you have so many teams. The bigger the school you have, the more sports you're going to have. So it's very difficult to be at all the practices. But there are key areas who I think you need to be at. At least get to one every other week just for an evaluation. How are things going? If there's a problem or issues with a team, I'd go a little bit more. But as a previous podcast, we talked about having an emergency drill with your teams. And I think it's important that the athletic director kind of oversee that. So if they're going to have an emergency drill, let the AD know as a coach and be there to kind of supervise and see the loopholes that you may or may not see during some type of emergency drill or special event. That way you know that the coaches have it under control or need a little bit of direction. But being at every practice is going to be very difficult. But you do need to evaluate the coaches, not only at their games, but at their practices too. As far as games go, it's still difficult for every AD to be at every game. So you would want to have maybe an administrator or an assistant AD or someone to cover you. At my school, we had basketball games on campus. We had soccer games off campus. So that it's impossible to be at both. But you you work through it and make sure that things are covered and make sure that you as a person, as an AD, are virtually available for any incident. Don't be the ticket taker. Don't be the security guy. Make sure that you're available to be able to bounce around. As far as purchases go, I think it's important that you have a schedule and be consistent with your teams. You know, you buy uniforms every 4 years or every six, however you want to do it. Make sure that Title IX is included with that to make sure that your uniforms are consistent. And the purchases, as far as the district goes, make sure your principal signs off on it so that principal knows through a PO or anything that this is what you're buying for the team. And for fundraisers, also, that needs to go by principal and administration also, so that you are consistent and you are purchasing things that the team actually needs. I got criticized, I'd say about 5-6 years ago, my coach bought a second and third set of helmets for the football team. And it was not my money, it was fundraised, and that's what they wanted to do. And it was okayed, but the criticism was, how come the football team gets three sets of helmets and we only have one set of helmets for lacrosse or something like that? Well, the team made that decision and that was a fundraiser for them. And those I would run through the principal also, just to make sure everything is clean on that venue. And make sure that you are controlling the budgets, because they will spend money that they don't have and it can get you into the red real quick and into some problems. So yes, they do have a budget for their team, but you need to control that budget to know what is going on with those teams. And above all, be fair between all teams. You know, the golf team may not be making money, but you find money to buy them uniforms just as you would find money to buy basketball or soccer, boys and girls. So that's all I have for today, Jake.
That's really important stuff there. And I wish we had more time to do a deeper dive. I'm going to go and toss in a couple of my own observations on this idea of budgets and fundraising. I always tried to get my coaches to approach things from a needs and a wants standpoint. You know, you need helmets. You want that second or third set of helmet. You don't need it. You want it. So why are you fundraising? Why are you spending all this time and energy on something that, guys, you know, you really don't need? And the wants aren't bad things. You know, we, as an athletic department, we tried to cover those wants. But as you said, you know, the golf team, the tennis team, the cross country team, the swim team, you know, they have needs that we got to make sure we're covering too. So, you know, great stuff. If one of our listeners, as always, wants to reach out and pick your brain, and listeners, I certainly encourage you to do so. Dan, what's the best way they can get in touch with you?
They can email me at dcomeau19@comcast.net.
Okay. Well, another great episode. And for our listeners, we appreciate you tuning in today. Remember, the Zoom recordings of all of our interviews get uploaded to the Educational AD Podcast YouTube channel, so you can see as well as listen. Come back again next Tuesday for another episode of the Mentoring Minute, and just about every single day for new content in the Educational AD Podcast. Thanks for tuning in. We also want to say thanks to Hometown Ticketing, the leading digital ticketing provider to schools and colleges. You can find out more about what Hometown Ticketing can do for you and your program by going to hometownticketing.com and talk to their pros. Hometown Ticketing, simple and easy online ticketing.